Yeah, when I play pickup games or anything 6v6 related on Viaduct, I die like 50 times a match. I'm probably not even exaggerating. It's awful. I die like every push. We do have the game starting though, ladies and gentlemen, so this is going to be the second map, the Whales versus LG. Seabear, why don't you take us away?
Critscreen for Shade, by the way.
Oh my god, Critscreen first map. How cheeky. I love it. As we're going to reset 100 times here, I believe this is the second to last restart. There it is, one more. We are live. LG is going to be the red side, and the blue side is going to be Space Whales. Need to win this one to extend the series to the third map. I think we're all kind of hoping for that. We haven't seen a third map yet. Why not? It'd be fun. So we're going to see if Banny starts his million damage run here, or if Dummy can put up some damage of his own here. So looks like the early bomb is going to go. Both soldiers are going to kiss 500 feet above the ground, and that's actually going to go to Dave, who dropped Mezzer during that bomb. So Dave's going to get cleaned up, but his work has been done. Shade, on the other hand, still alive, doing quite well, actually, for himself, because he's staying back with Banny. And that Critscreek, they're going to be able to use it aggressively, I think. Although the scout is plus forwarding in. Clockwork versus everyone. No, he's going to get shut down by Sizer, so... First mid goes to LG, and they look pretty good with their crits in hand, so...
Yeah, Banny's getting reloaded. He doesn't want to waste too much ammo right now, although he will lay one or two traps, maybe. But you see, he's trying to keep at least five or four stickies in his launcher at any given time to make sure that when the whales eventually show their faces... And yes, whales do have faces. They're kind of large, but whatever. That he is going to be ready to pop that crits anytime and just destroy people with as many loaded projectiles as possible. It looks like the whales are mostly on that cliff, but they haven't shown their med yet. And actually, Mezzer is on the cliff. So if Banny realizes that, he's going to call that crits right away. So far, it hasn't happened yet. And actually, a big bomb in from a soldier trying to do some damage to Shade. Shade taking one hit. And there goes Hero.
Dude, Blaze is so good. What I don't like what LG's doing, sorry just to take it from you, Salz, they're not getting any eyes really on the positioning of the other team, and actually they just gave up the point. Really curious play by LG, they're just sitting on this crits. Mezzer at 70% uber now, and he's gonna have to pop this crit eventually. There it is, and it's not a great crit so far. Mezzer just kind of skirting the... Oh, he's back into the sticky! Are you kidding me, Mezzer? Ah! Louding how well he's been playing, and he just kind of backs his truck up into that sticky. Like, oops, oh, that's bad. Unfortunately, all the talk about how a bad crit it was going to be. That's not true, because they're going to kill the medic and win the point back with it. Jeez! So LG still looks good. I don't agree with a lot of what happened there for LG, but they made it work, DJC.
Yeah, so far, I'm just noticing that it seems like Space Whales are ready to play against the LG that they saw earlier. They expected, like, the initial mid, they expected Dave to do some long wraparound play, go behind. Dave just got directly on top of Mezzer and shot him twice and killed him. Maybe LG are just playing a little bit of a mind game, changing up their strategy, doing some radically different things. But it looks like Space Whales are pushing pretty aggressively on the mid here, so we'll recapture it with being down a minute in time.
They will. I kind of watched the Blaze Bomb in there, and he screwed the Pooch on a little bit, but it doesn't even matter as he took enough attention. Thing is, Shade's still in the Critscreek. I don't think he's died yet. And LG are going to be able to quickly recapture this with their player advantage, with the fact they almost have the crits ready to go. Actually, Mezzer almost has an Uber of his own. Is that the... Yeah, it's a regular Uber gun. Regular Medigun. Uber gun is, of course, what Pure likes to call it.
Yo, somehow style, like, Mezzer was healing so effectively that he caught up with Shade. Shade should have gotten that Uber quickly, quicker than the other medic, but he didn't. And they're going to be able to have a big, big advantage off of crits versus regular. They pop in time.
Oh my god.
They were very aware that Shade never died. And there they go. They're pushing in deep. They haven't gotten a lot done with this Uber, though. In fact, Clockwork goes down. Wow, a big brick of the Uber. It was a great position, but they just didn't do enough burst damage. Though Dummy is trying to clear him out there. Boomer and Dummy drop two, and the crits was popped during that. So it's charging right now. Shade at 40% in building. Very fast, the Critscreek builds. Whales did recapture that point, but they are a minute down. It's 108 for LG. They're going to start counting right now, and 203 on the clock. So LG in great position to take round one, Sal.
And LG, they spot their opponents this time around, trying to get more eyes on. You do see the whales kind of jumping in on this the non-cliff side. I don't really know what to call it. Stair side, I guess. But it sounds like Shade is ready to charge once again. As soon as they spot Mezzer, they're going to want to get that kill on him. And Mezzer is still with the stairs. LG, once again, just kind of backing up and not being too terribly aggressive. Now, you see, of course, Banny, once he spotted out Mezzer, he was like, okay, I know exactly where this guy is. It's not working, though.
Well, it worked enough. There's two pipes. He doesn't even need a crit to drop YZ. Getting Mezzer there. Mezzer, if he stays alive, which I believe he is, he's at his spawn with his very strong soldiers. It's going to have a big advantage here. Even more of an advantage because Shade has crits. So if they are able to get on him with this Uber, they should be able to retake. But look at the clock, Sal. 15 seconds of counting for LG. They need to get on the point quickly, does Mezzer and company, and they're going to be able to do that right now. Dummy's able to open it up with a nice frag onto Sizer. Looking at the flank, though, let's look at the Uber derp, as Mezzer is going to pop his, but it's the most effective in the world. Shade sitting at 80% crits. They needed to get Shade here, but Dave with a nice bomb, and with the Banny spam, the ever-persistent Banny roller spam, they're going to be able to get this easily. Banny does go down to Clockwork, but that crits is ready, and it looks like it's going to be a Sizer. A hero crit. Hit the meat. He got one. He's not able to get that scout, though. A little bit of a brick from Hero. Thought that he was going to be able to clean up those three, but the times two on the point. Here comes the bomb, trying to stop it. Desperately trying to stop it. Sizer just pecking away. Able to drop him. Dummy with the last chance. Demo bomb in. It's going to have to hold the point off. Can he hit the meat? Can he hit the pipes? Oh, no.
No.
Sizer drops him down. So
yeah,
a nice comeback attempt, but 1-0 in favor of LG.
That time disparity actually was really bad. 1:30 versus 0 time. Of course, it means that the whales only held it for half the time their opponents did. And now they are getting out to this second mid fight as Dummy is going to start laying
crits versus crits. Yeah, double crit.
Wow, both medics are running crits at middle. That's crazy. I haven't seen that in a while. But on Viaduct, you can kind of play more defensively and really keep your medic alive. Tyrone is going to go down first to the Boomer Bomb. Very dangerous bomb indeed. And YZ able to drop Sizer after the Dummy pill. So nice two opening frags for the whales. Not sure if both teams are aware of the situation that they both have crits. So they're both probably thinking, all right, we got to use this quick before they get theirs. But looks like I think they're actually aware as they backed out to regroup here. So Sal, I'm curious to see how the crits versus crits works out.
Banny's ready. He's looking. He's got those eagle eyes out, waiting to see where his enemies are, and he does, I think, spot them. But Mezzer is so far back right now that Banny thinks he may not be able to get the damage done. And you do see some rockets flying in towards LG, and Tyrone and Dave are both very hurt right now. In comes the crits, not hitting. Both crits are popped.
Oh,
you're going to have to see which team can actually do better. These artillery demos are not hitting anything right now. Dummy and Banny are trying so hard, but the crits are over, and neither one did any damage.
That was, pretty sad, Sal. both pop, and they're just tossing stickies that go about 20 feet too short at each other. It's pretty funny. I was hoping that we'd see a little more firework action there between the two teams. That's all right. It's all good. As we stand right now, 2 minutes and 13 seconds left for the whales, and they're about to start counting again. Only about 2:45 for LG. I hit that on the dot, as Banny's going to die at the very end of that. So I think we're going to see some stalemating out. Both medics, of course, stayed alive during all that, and they both have crits. So we'll see if there's maybe a more fun crit-v-crit action instead of tossing stickies
it's
in the general direction
soon.
Of med.
It's coming up soon. They already have it ready to go. At least Shade does. And he's going to have to try and get his team in. Looks like he did through that stair side. Crits coming in right away. Not dealing quite enough damage here, though. And once again, the crits is going to get popped for both teams. Now, you have it actually popping a scout this time. And Shade going down to Clockwork. Crits in Clockwork, never a bad idea. And LG losing so many players now, Seabear.
That's how you do it, man. Give it to Clockwork. He's going to find the meat, and he did. I love the sound of crits scatter. You know it's hitting for 200. That is awesome, and looking over at Shade, see if he's given up the crit fight. He has, so he's going regular. Mezzer skirted away with 15 health, and he's going to stay on crits, so he's going to have it ready to go, but LG eventually will have advantage, IDOC. DJC, I haven't called you IDOC yet, that's kind of weird. There's about a minute left on the clock here in a bit for the whales. They're dominant in this second round.
Yeah, it's very weird. We're going to see the big bombs come in here and try to take Mezzer down. Banny, Hero, Sizer all dead. Nice pipe by Dummy at the end to take Dave AC down. I was going to say, this is some very weird use of crits. Actually, the crits does come out from Mezzer, so that's very good for LG. But usually when you crits, you want to jump something in. You want to create a distraction. You want to open space. You don't rely on the crits creek to make space itself. So I think the adaptation the whales made by just critsing a scout who doesn't need to clear space, who can just shoot from wherever the hell he wants and kill Shade in two shots is a really smart one.
Yeah, the Uber is ready to go. Mezzer, during that suicide, did pop his. The Uber, red Uber, is going to be popped, and they're going to gain the point back with this. Mezzer, if he can stay alive, will have crits up very shortly. He's at 75% and building. He is going to watch his team die around him. He's going to be in trouble here. Probably needs to back out in time. Banny is pressuring him. Does not want that crits to be popped. Banny's doing quite a bit here onto Mezzer, who sneaks away. Was getting chipped away by sticky damage, but Mezzer sneaks off, as he tends to do in this series, and he'll live to crit another day, and that day might be very soon, Sal, as he's ready to go with Dummy.
No, he's copping it right now. Dummy not able to. Oh, no, he did hit Hero right away. Trying to hit Banny as well. I think Banny might have taken a hit, but no, Sizer's down. Thing is, Mezzer died from Sizer real fast, so that was quite effective. Now we have soldiers kind of bombing in at each other, both of them hitting the skybox there as Blaze and Dave AC end up dying in a shower of Gibbs. But Dummy's going to go ahead and lay down some sticks on the point now. And LG are so far behind in the time, I don't think they're going to be able to do anything about this.
No, Dummy's waiting for Sizer. He's got 11 stickies waiting for him. Make it about 7. Is he bets on Sizer? Looks like LG's going to take it. But they've got the pretty easy task, DJC, of holding for 2 minutes 20. That happens a lot in a very even invite match.
Yeah, I mean, a 220 hold isn't actually out of the question because they do have Uber right now, but here comes the big bomb from Blaze. Actually just circles back around and goes to his cliff, realizing he couldn't get in. It's basically like they have to kill 2 minutes with one Uber, and that one Uber can probably get you about 40 seconds on so, but oh, and Banny goes down with a nice bomb, the combined aggression from Boomer and Dummy, and they're still trying to get it in here. They have Mezzer actually goes down at the end of the fight, and that's not what you want to see when you're trying to make that play.
No. Nice work by Sizer. Had the decision to try to chase a bomber who went behind him, but he decided to stay with his medic and did a lot of damage with that Uber there. And all the time, I said it was impossible in sarcastic tones, but LG's making it look like it can be a reality. They've already ticked off about a minute, and the whales are kind of just throwing dudes at Shade now, who's they're recapping and they're going to win. I wasn't paying attention. I thought that they had that. I was watching Banny on the flank, like, dumping damage on people. And then they just won the game! But yeah, like
well,
I said,
yeah,
2 minutes and 30 seconds. Very, very hard, too impossible to hold, just in the course of how the game is played. Eventually, the faster spawns, it's just you'll just lose. But anyway,
I tell you what, Blaze did so well there, Seabear. He didn't do hardly any damage, but he was behind enemy lines, just avoiding them and distracting them for so long. And we do see Mezzer once again on the crits. Is Shade as well is the question. And right now, no, he's actually on the regular medigun, a little bit behind in the Uber. So if no, Dummy has actually died. It would be very difficult for Mezzer to make use of this crit. You see him healing a soldier right now. Dave not able to quite get away there. Missed a flubbed a rocket. But you know, LG, they're going to hold the point here. Looks like Dummy is alive, but I don't know if he's going to be there in time to kill Shade. Shade so close to the Uber right now, and he is going to get it just in time. Oh,
that
man.
Sticky was in Banny's jaw. It was like in his mouth right when Shade popped. It was bang, bang. Great pop by Shade. He popped it right when he saw that sticky coming towards Banny. Gotta save Banny, as that crit is going to be completely bopped. So now what the whales have to do is try to rebuild this and catch Shade and company. But actually, they're going to win the spam battle, which is not often to do against a Banny demo. Banny, while I say his name, gets a nice air rocket onto a flying soldier, and he's plus forwarding into Mezzer. Wow, what a pipe! He just flicks his gun to the left and drops YZ-50, splashes the medic as well. Banny 1v3s them back. Such a strong nerd. Sizer comes in to help him in the end, but wow, Banny.
Now, Dummy's gotten quite a few kills here, and he was perhaps single-handedly able to keep things going for his team there, but Sizer, good old Paul, sneaks around behind him and gets a nice two-shot kill. Clockwork's trying to make some space for the rest of his team here to push forward, and there you go, the whales will finally get their first capture of this round after a minute of their opponents holding it. The whales do have their crits ready to go, but once again, Shade has his Uber. YZ-50 in an interesting position here, I think in his enemy's house, and he is kind of waiting for them to appear. He spots them coming out of that main entrance, the middle area. And what do you think, Seabear? How's this going to go? Looks like the Uber's popped early for Shade. I crashed.
Yeah, Blaze is doing a great job. He and I think Wiseup's Clockwork just overran the flank. Clockwork is fighting a big 1v1 here. That Uber did get into the point. They've done quite a bit, but here comes the crits in retaliation. They're not going to get any crit kills, but that scared him and opened it up. Tyro with a huge shotgun play onto Clockwork. Ty was at 2 health, and he's going to roll in here. I guess he's feeling very brave as our streamer crashed, unfortunately. So,
Seabear. How are you watching that Chris Cregan didn't notice that Banny double airshot Dummy so hard that Dummy probably de-aged 17 years?
That's probably why we all crashed. That's probably why we crashed.
The game couldn't handle that.
I think Lang caught it on stream because the chat just lost its mind in every way imaginable.
I was watching Blaze. He was on the other side of the map. I thought there was going to be a big Blaze play. It was actually a pretty big play, but not as big as the double. Ah, you missed that. Oh, I'm so sad, Sal. I keep on using Shade. You're not Shade. You're Sal. Hi, Sal.
Yeah, I totally missed it. It was all my fault, of course. But at least it was caught on camera for future action in moments of glory and whatever else, because you know that'll be a moment of glory. The shot
moments of shame when casters miss doubles, yeah. Dumb cast, an idiot. Sizer gets dropped up here. Nice opening picks here as LG's trying to recap middle. Looking at the clock, the whales have done a great job. They've run off about 2 minutes in a row here. That 158's been on the board for a while for LG.
Oh my god. Shade and Tyrone were just sitting in spawn there. They're not able to get out and do the damage yet. They know that Mezzer still has that crits.
Yeah, and the crits, I was going to say, hasn't done really anything. I mean, they haven't gotten a lot of crits damage. They haven't caught them in between Ubers, but it's still effective.
Oh, what I think a it's just jump. Outplayed.
Wow. Yeah,
I was watching
bomb.
Shades cam. Yeah, that double bomb. Now, it actually may have backfired here as Boomer and Blaze both died, but the crits is ready to go completely uncontested here. If Dummy wants to get in and pop this crits right now, he will. Can Shade Woo! Avoid the damage? It looks like Dummy's doing some good damage to Dave right now. Not going to hit Banny with that sticky. I'm surprised he didn't detonate it right there in his face, but Banny kills Dummy with a huge pipe, and that crit's not really that effective. LG did capture the point. They are going to continue their reign of terror here for a little while. I think they're getting pressured, though, Seabear.
Yeah, I'm going to crash as well, so I'm a little worried that this is some kind of weird ESCA thing that like happened before. I hope that's not the case, because I feel like this game is going to go down to the wire. But I did get crashed out, so why don't you keep going?
I will keep going, of course, DJC. I hope you're able to watch this as well. Boomer jumping straight into his opponents right now, and you do see... oh my god, so many good kills going down. YZ50, Boomer, Dummy, all of them taking an opponent out, and that does mean three down for LG. They've got a crit ready to go once again. They're going to pop it on nobody, actually. A bit of a mistake there. Shade has 82%, and I guess they thought they spotted him out there, but oh well. You know,
so little time left, though, and LG are so far away from the point. They have 8 seconds to get there. They're going to have to jump in. Not even sure if their Uber's going to make it in time. Soldier is near the point, gets launched. Why is he jumping into the air? They need cap time so badly.
They got someone on it. So you know what? Actually... Yeah, they did. Dave was probably doing a good thing there, and he does jump in once again, trying to get some capture time. Not going to be quite enough here. Space Wheels will bring it 2-1. I think I know what Dave was going for there, though. He was trying to get around behind his enemies, distract them from the rest of the team from getting in. It was a very risky play. Almost paid off, but
it was just a matter of, like, at the end of that Uber, there were two people surrounded by five, and Dave AC could easily contribute to that fight. Look at this rollout from Dummy, so aggressive on the point. Both Scouts and the Soldier rushing tunnel side here. Space Whale's denying it pretty well, but Banny's going to come in with a late spam and take down Boomer. And look at Dave AC. He is sky high. His head is in the skybox, but it's not going to matter because Blade Dylan takes down Shade, and that will put this crit streak at 75% right now. With no heals up on LG, this is going to be very intense, very good, very clutch situation for Tim Dummy Olsen to show his Metal Salamancer.
Well, it does seem like it's the perfect opportunity right now. He's going to go ahead and lay one down on Banny, getting revenge for all the times he has died to the double air pipes. And he actually hit Tyrone, yeah, with a beautiful little sticky there. So Dummy is on fire right now. And he's going to go ahead and lay down some sticks on the house. What on earth was that? I don't even know.
Fast sell. I don't even know if you guys are aware, but we've been without video for quite a while. We kind of said it, but no one's reconnected yet. So Lang is trying to get back in the game. So we'll do our best to try to keep you abridged of what's exactly is going on here as far as times go. Right now, I think LG took the initial mid and held it for a big 9 seconds as now the whales are clicking away and they're at 2:30. So right now it is in the hands of whales. They are up 2-1 here on Viaduct, trying to extend it to a third map here. They've killed three LG members. Shade and company are backing out, and Mezzer is still running crits. So yeah, we're gonna have to get Lang the IP back so we can get back into the game here, but we're sorry.
Okay, well, I've given Lang mine. Hopefully he'll be able to get into that one. And we do have Shade almost with his Uber ready to go. Now Hero is on the Sniper. This is the first off-class we've seen all game from any of these teams. So Hero going Sniper is an interesting move. Actually, you know, he did swap back to Scout, so never mind. We do have LG starting to try to push towards the fight. They lose Sizer right away. And Banny has taken the Uber. Mezzer has not had to pop his Crits Krieg yet. And Blaze and Boomer both go down. All right, so we do have our cameraman back in that game now. You guys can see the video. I hope it is just as beautiful and awesome as you expected. The crits is about ready to go, so you picked a good time to get back into the game. It's going to get popped on Dummy right now. Not doing quite enough damage yet. Mezzer going to take a lot of damage here from a bombing soldier. He does retreat, but that shuts down the crits very effectively. Clockwork going down there, and Seabear, all of a sudden, we're in a position where the whales, they hold the point, but they're looking a little tenuous.
Well, they're looking great as far as the time goes. They're clicking under minute 10 here. And I find it just amazing what they're doing, considering how ineffective their crits has been, and they haven't run Uber at all. I don't know how LG is not winning. DJC, I was going to ask you, this crits has done really not that much, but they're making it work. It seems like that double soldier bomb to force the pop, I mean, you could do that with any Uber. It's just working, and LG finally caps the point, and they're at 240 and counting. But the crits, whereas it hasn't done much, they're still winning.
They're not even relying on the crits. Clockwork went in there, got like three kills, was dancing around forever. The double Solar Bomb actually comes, gets the Uber Force out. So this is one situation where we're going to need the crit screen to come up big for the Space Whales. Mezra is already back in the spawn. They are down there, two soldiers, so they'll want to delay and keep themselves alive for another few seconds here. But basically, man, you don't even need a crit screen when Clockwork is playing as well as he is. Look at his score right now, and that's pretty much all kills. It's not inflated. He has 25 kills at the end of rounds. That was at the end of three rounds. I haven't checked the live one yet, but it's probably pretty nuts.
Real fast, I know the action's taking place here. You see the crits being popped up. And again, not a very great crit at all. No kills being made. Banny and company hold the point, and the times are getting closer together here. A minute 55 as Blaze gets chopped down by Banny. I believe that was an air sticky being shot by Big Grant. Sizer and company on the point, and they own it. Nice time up here, about a full minute and still counting here. Real fast, though, guys, this is specifically to the mods in the stream. Chill out with the banning of the people posting links to other streams. The Mr. Slim stream, they've been talking and pumping up us up the entire time, and we're definitely okay with them, those links being put in there. Hopefully you guys stay with us and keep this browser open either way, but if you want to watch Slim's stream or someone else's, go for it. It's not, we're not banning anymore for that, guys, so stop. Thank you.
Oh, YZ50 with a nice kill on Dave. That was a beautiful thing, and it looks like he does control the cliff right now, so he's going to pressure LG from that side just a little bit. And that does mean LG will back off for now. They don't want to try and take too much flanking damage from over there. They're actually very very grouped up right now. Mezra, though, at such low health that if he does try to go in for a crits or anything, it's not going to work. He does still have the crits, and now that he's gotten a health kit, he's going to have to wait for the Uber to finish up here. Blaze forced the Uber out of Shade, and now the crits can go at any time. Will he deal the damage? Right now, Soldier's bombing in.
No.
Tyro's down, but oh my god, Mezra gets taken out by that awesome bomb by Dave.
I think it's time for Mezra to go regular Uber. They're in danger of losing this round that they had no business even being close to losing. They're up almost 2 minutes. Here we go. Blaze is trying to turn the tides here. Gets just destroyed by the scouts, pushing him across the middle point. 30 seconds and counting for LG. Banny and company turning this round all the way back. Thought it was clearly Whales. They're going to tie it up here unless the Whales can pull something special out here in the last minute. And as I say that, Mezra does have his regular Uber gun back out. Will it be enough? Shade has a big advantage if he can stay alive. Dave AC did go down. There's three down in LG as the Whales do get the point back. 15 seconds left on the clock for LG. 50 and counting for LG. They're going to, or for Whales, they're going to have to kite this LG Uber coming in here. And looks like Shade and company Sal are going to bring it in on their left side. And this is probably the most important Uber of the match so far.
Yeah, will LG be able to capture this point and tie it up? The Uber's coming in right now, but actually this Uber is being forced away once again by some beautiful play by Blaze. He is just distracting the crap out of so many players on LG right now. They're starting to get the capture. They've taken down Blaze finally behind their lines, but you do see the Whales in a decent position to try and recapture this. They've got 10 seconds to do so. Here comes the Uber from the Whales. They need to cap right now, and this would actually put them up 3-1 if they get this. They've got players on. They have to deal with Banny, though. He is going to be able to deal a lot of damage to their team. He takes down takes down Dummy. Mezra getting destroyed off this point. Tyrone still jumping in, and Banny's still up here. I think this round is going to go to LG. They're going to be able to hold on to this. It is an overtime, and nothing the Whales can do. It's tied up. That was a close round, and I'm starting to lose my voice already.
Uh-oh, that's not good. That was a nice round. I really like what I saw there out of both teams. Mezra now, I think he's probably done with his crits. He's going to stay on regular Uber. Like I said before, they really got nothing done with the crits. They were still winning in spite of it, but it started really costing them as Mezra couldn't protect himself to the bomb, couldn't pop. You know, the crits is going to stop you from two bombing soldiers on your face. As here we go, we're at mid-fight. Another 5! 2-2 in a close series like we hoped it would be. Mezra does go down early to Tyrone, so his second Roamer bomb paying off there, and actually, Tyrone is still alive, so maybe a splash rocket as he's crawling on the point now with his medic. Clockwork goes down as well. We are seeing LG swarm the point as it just opens up, and they're going to be able to get the first cap here standing on it. Both medics, I'm sorry, Mezra did die earlier, of course, and Shade's going to have his ready to go right now, so a nice mid-win, guys. LG looks good here, trying to come back after being down 2-1.
Yeah, right now a lot of chaos, chaotic fighting going down everywhere. Dummy, the first casualty of this particular battle, and that's going to make LG feel pretty solid. They're not going to have to worry too much about crits coming into their faces here. Actually, though, there is no crits, so Mezra is once again on that regular Uber, and he is nowhere close to having it yet. Shade could pop this anytime just to save his own skin, but of course, usually you want to use an Uber for a little bit more than just saving your own skin. We'll see what he actually does with this. As right now, it looks like it is going to be very defensive.
Banny got pushed out of the fight there, but a really nice sprawl by him. Hero with a big double is able to drop Blaze and YZ50 on the point, and that's going to slow it down. The force attempt out of three whale members completely stuffed by LG. Mezzer and company are going to repush with their Uber, but a minute has been run off already by LG, and Banny is starting to really heat up. He's got Boomer, and as long as they're able to keep control of men alive here, Banny able to do a ton of damage. This Uber, it's tough to make anything happen with it. They're going to have to pop early and close a lot of ground to get to LG. So LG really playing with the advantage right now, and I like them to close this out right now if they keep playing like this.
Yeah, your prediction still may turn out true. It could end up being a 4-2 game with LG actually coming from behind to win it, but Hero taken down first by a nice kill by Dummy. The Uber is, of course, in, just like you predicted, and now we have the counter Uber from LG. My voice is definitely going down the drain here, so I'm going to have to start laying off a little bit. But this is an awesome game so far. LG just kind of sitting here on the point, barely holding it. And there goes Mezzer. Beautiful kill by Tyrone and Sizer.
Tyrone and Sizer take doubles, both of them. So that's four down from the two original members of LG here. Nice play by Tyrone, keeping his cool, loading that fourth rocket and dropping the jumping scout. And that's going to get yet another extension of time here for LG. They're up 2 minutes and counting, 3 minutes. It's just staring them right in the face. Blaze's creative jumps have not paid off recently. He's just getting destroyed. Shade did get hurt. He's back. The Ubers, Mezzer is down by quite a bit, but nice play by the Whales. After all this Uber hold and attempts to push with Uber, they just walked on the point and finally got it. So maybe that's all it takes. We do see a lot of frags going off here. Is Shade going to make it out? He will. Just duck in. He's going to be able to regroup with his team and respawn and still have a bit of an advantage, Sal, as he has it. And Mezzer's only at 70, so a chance for him to get Mezzer close to getting his Uber.
Okay. I'm confused here. How many times has Shade actually died during this match? Because we were talking about how Mezzer only died like 7 times. I swear I haven't even like seen Shade in the kill feed dying. So this is looking pretty good for them so far. They are going to be able to try to repush this fairly quickly and may in fact go up in the points if they can do it successfully. They are already on the point, popping that Uber just a little bit earlier from Mezzer, but you're going to see Shade multi-Ubering, flashing a lot of his teammates here, which will waste a lot of that Uber real fast. It depletes... it depletes faster as you flash more people. Mezzer!
Oh, he did go down. He got pushed into the skybox, and everyone looks up, like, licks their chops at the medic in the skybox. Everyone shoots everything they can at him. LG does get the point momentarily, Sal, as it's 40 seconds now left, and Bro Whales have the point. They're at 2 minutes, so they need to have a great hold here to run this round back.
It's not impossible, as we've said before. I mean, LG, I think they just did it, didn't they? But, you know, it doesn't look so good right now for the Whales. They are once again losing the point. Mezzer actually did just come up a little bit faster. Shade, though, going to catch up in the Ubers very quickly unless Mezzer has gone crits, which he has not. He's gone regular old Uber. So, Mezzer standing on top of Sticky's not always the best of ideas, but he'll manage to kite these things away for now. Beautiful surf by him, actually, just to get up onto the cliff, and there goes everybody on LG. In fact, Shade down, too. So I was just saying I hadn't seen Shade die, but now that I mention it, you know, maybe he does die a little bit.
You kind of jinxed him, Sal, because he's died three or four times here. DJ, I haven't heard you recently. Have we been missing anything? Anything that stepped up? I've seen Blaze's play not quite work out as well, although they are coming back in this round.
I've been playing with my dog. That's my analysis.
Wicko dog as a big dummy bomb coming in here. I'm sorry, it's the Banny bomb as I got my colors mixed up. It's not going to work out. Mezzer seems to have Banny's number as far as dodging. I've seen Banny whiff quite a few times onto Mezzer. That scary dodge as we do see a soldier touching the skybox. Michael Jordan over here is going to get pushed back. Actually still alive somehow, so a very creative little play there by Tyrone, I guess. Get pushed into the skybox, not going to die. Hey, it's all right.
Surprisingly, he's had 18 health like forever, but nobody was able to follow that up. So yeah, he did survive very effectively.
Yeah, Mezzer has his Uber advantage. I kind of said this was not going to happen just because of the huge lead that LG got off to in this round, but looking at the scores now, they're about to pass each other, and that's pretty crazy. Looks like Red is getting back into, LG's getting back into their spawn. They're going to build this one Uber, looking at the advantages when they get this, and they get everyone spawned up. Even though Chad just dies now, and Sizer gets killed inside of his own spawn by YZ50, who's heated up. But they are going to spawn pretty fast, Sal, and they're going to have a chance in here. 10, 15 seconds, I'm sorry, and counting here is the lead. Here comes the Uber. Banny is going to fly in there. Oh, he's caught the combo! Banny says hello and goodbye to Mezzer and Blaze. That might be all that LG needed. Banny with a pipe on the clockwork. He's got it. He's heating up. A pipe on the boomer. Banny brings it back. 0 seconds left on the clock for the whales, but they do not have the point. Their medic just spawned. Huge play by LG.
Now, Dummy did just get a wicked series of damage, stickies and pipes onto Dave to kill him. Predicted that he was going to jump in very accurately. And Dummy's going to try and lead the push, the counter push here to capture it for the whales. Got to be careful about this soldier jumping onto his med, but, you know, they're going to get a couple people on here. And it is a double overtime now. The whales trying to capture their opponents, trying to stop this. And LG actually do have enough fires, but it's just going to take one or two on the point. It is so close. Oh, my God, Boomer. Can Boomer say no?
Oh, my Lord, Sal. What? Dummy is going to get back in here. This is not going to run out of time. Dummy is going to have a chance. Here he comes, flying in. They left the point. This fight is going to go on. I don't know if the respawners are going to make
the
it.
The Uber.
But there's going to be more blue guys when this Uber is done. They have to make something happen with this Uber. They've done it so far with two. But look at all the blue guys swarming the point. This still is anyone's fight. Blaze goes down, and the time runs up. They had to get on the point, but what an end
my God.
To that round. Sal, holy crap, that is awesome stuff there, jeez.
That's the two of us screaming at the same time felt pretty much like a caster explosion. That's what just happened right there.
Benny has 550 damage per minute.
Wait, sorry, what was that?
Benny has 550 damage per minute.
Yeah, he's done a lot. Clockwork, though, is going to open up wait, not an overtime here? I thought this was like, they switched to... Okay, this isn't live, right, okay. Yeah, it's not live. I'm sorry to make that sound important, but it was not live. We're fine. Oh, that was a crazy round, though. DJC, just the end of that round, I didn't see Shade was so close to Uber, but that's really what saved them, Shade's Uber, because there was about a 5-on-2 situation for about 3 or 4 seconds, but Shade had an Uber, that saved him there, but wow, what an end.
It was really nice awareness by Sizer. The second that everyone was gone from the point, he whipped out the sword and started just beating himself in the face. I think honestly, if he had not done it, if he had waited even half a second, they might not have gotten the Uber in time before the pressure came. They were able to pop and buy everything.
Suddenly the whales are door me here. They need to win two to extend this match to a third map, or their LAN is over and they'll go home in third place. LG fighting to get into a place in the grand finals to play mix-up tomorrow, nice and bright and early, I think 10:30 Central Time. But here we are. We are at the mid-fight, and it looks like a good one overall for the whales, and they are on the red side now, switching the shirts. Banny is on the point trying to fight everybody here, but he is probably going to get cleaned up. Oh, he's just dancing around the damage. There goes the rest of his team. Mezra is jumping around, staying alive, and that's going to be basically everybody. Soldier flying in and Tyrone is down, so pretty easy win. YZ has 4 on the board, so that's a lot of kills for YZ50.
Yeah, and you noticed there were actually 2 pistol kills there at the end. That's kind of indicative of the health that LG had for most of that fight. Every single one of them took a ton of damage except for Banny, and so Banny was sitting there alive like, what's wrong, team? And the rest of his team is like, we can't fight because we have 2 health. So, yeah, it was pretty awful for LG there. And you do see them forcing an Uber very nicely. Dave jumping in and getting taken out. Tyrone is still at large. And you're going to see the whales just trying to lay as much... oh my god, how did Banny get in there? Dummy was like laying a trap and Banny was behind him. Dummy was like, where did you come from?
Banny doing his best Dave AC impersonation, flying around the map, collecting health packs, and comes back in late into the fight to kill Dummy. That's pretty special when your demo can do that kind of stuff. Just the air control and the ability to circle the map like a roamer. And that's big play there, obviously, like you said, cycling that Uber for the red guys. LG's going to come in with a big advantage, but it is going to be in the hands of Tyrone. Banny is still on resupply, respawn as he's coming back in. They actually didn't pop there, guys, so nice push by LG. Shade milks it away. It's very scary in that situation. You don't know if you're going to get hit by a pipe all of a sudden. The burst damage can happen, but they got the point, and they're in great position to run it back here. Nice hold, though, by the whales. Got 2 minutes off, and they did force the pop.
Yeah, Shade went down to 13 health there. He was so close to death, so it was a very good Uber pop from him. Maybe even a little bit too risky, but you know, it paid off. It paid off. Tyrone just trying to spam into spawn a little bit here, but he will back away, seeing that many players kind of staring him down like, dude, this is our turf. Get out.
Yep, LG is going to have to kite this. Nice opening by Banny onto Clockwork. Former teammates going at it. It's fun to watch those two. So good going at it with each other. Push is going to come in here from the red guys. The Uber was popped and is running its course right now. They have taken control of the point. Haven't made a ton of frags. They did get an important one into Banny. I'm looking at Dave AC right now. Is he thinking about doing something crazy? No, he's going to get back to the comfort, the loving arms of his medic Shade. And looks kind of like a 5-point match right now, DJC. These guys are just leapfrogging each other, and now it's back into LG's hands to try to leapfrog, and the score is pretty close, so about 30 seconds and counting.
It really felt like in the first half, Blaze was never really finishing his kills. He was getting in, he was doing damage. He had the big moments at times, but right now he's actually getting in, finishing off his own blade.
Shade, one kill, Shade! Oh my god!
Dude, Shade is nuts sometimes. Like, that dodge right there, I thought for sure he was done. And I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I gotta point out, Shade's counter strafe there at the very end just threw Blaze off. And if you can make a guy as good as Blaze miss, you have a pretty awesome dodge.
Yeah, right now, of course, LG holding the point, and they, once again, they were able to push forward into six players without popping their Uber. They take down Clockwork right away. They take down YZ50. No scouts left, who are so crucial to this map on Viaduct. It does mean that pretty much everybody's going to have to back off. Blaze got in and tried to pop the Uber on Shade, not able to do that either. This is not looking too good for the Whales right now. They're going to get tied up in time very shortly here, and then I think LG will be able to hold this for quite a lot longer.
We're going to have an Uber versus Uber here in a bit, although Mezzer is getting spammed out right now. A forward hold being employed by LG, and they might get Mezzer. He's at 20 health right now. Whoa. He's going to regen away, but that's a little bit too close. If that were to happen, if he were to go down, nice force in the meantime here. Sizer does clean up Ben, but YZ50, or Ben, was able to force the pop, and now Mezzer's sitting at 100%. Here comes the bomb to open it up. I believe that's Blaze trying his best to get Shade after that awesome dodge work. Sizer's able to pistol him down, and Blaze is a little bit fast there. I think that he probably would have been a nice addition to this push. Clockwork and company are on it. Mezzer has not popped yet. Looking for the medic, maybe to try to push forward. Shade is tucked away up top, pretty safe. And they're going to recap. So really nice play by Whales. And this is a very, very close round, Sal. 52 seconds for LG to 115 for the Whales.
Yeah, the Whales holding the point right now, so they're going to be able to tie this time up. But LG, they've been pushing masterfully off Uber right now. They're going to have to try and force the Uber out of Mezzer very quickly here. And you're probably going to see Dave and Tyrone both jumping in to do just that. But Tyrone down very quickly, so is Sizer. They were able to get the Uber pop. Dave's now down as well, but Shade's going to have that Uber. And once his teammates respawn here in the next couple of seconds, they'll be able to push right back in.
The question is, can the Whales do what LG have been able to do so far? And that's pop them early and get back. LG, of course, screwed it up last time where they just kind of let the Whales walk onto the point and take control there. Looking at the clock, 52 seconds for LG, 35 seconds for the Whales and counting. So LG definitely needs to get out there soon. You have 30 seconds, but you don't want time to run off because, like we saw at the end of last map, it can get pretty crazy towards the end. And any additional time could be a round saver. But here we go. In the meantime, LG's pushing up. Banny and company.
Oh,
a heavy. Spam, but there's a heavy right there. Hello, says Blaze. And he's going to go down, but did a nice damage. Got Hero with a frag, and they're going to turn it off only at times one on the point.
Mezzer
kind of
in trouble. Oh, no. Mezzer got caught out there.
Looking at the clock, though, Sal, 5 seconds, and now is actually 6 seconds left on the board, which is basically a cap and win situation if you're red. Blue has to hold it for 45 and counting, but like you said, with the medic going down, with Mezzer going down, it's a chance here. And remember, guys, 40 seconds, and we'll see LG versus mix-up. So the Whales are going to have to make something happen right now. It's do-or-die time.
Well, they're getting onto the point already. Their opponents are giving them a lot of space here. Shade doesn't have the Uber yet. The soldiers are going to try and bomb in to stop this. They don't want the Whales to capture, but it looks like the Whales probably will capture here. Dave AC and Tyrone both down. Clockwork eating a huge kill by Banny, though. Banny happy about that one. And LG once again stopping this cap so effectively. Mezzer, can he escape this time around? We'll see. It looks like he actually... Oh, he took down Banny with
does
the crossbow. Are you joking?
Banny, oh my god, I didn't even see that. Banny got crossbow. That's actually really big because Dummy's right here. Mezzer's going to be able to hook up with him and they're going to have a chance to get onto the point. Look at the bottom of your screen. There's going to be quite a lot of time before the overtime runs out. Clockwork is going to jump on the point along with this scout. He does lose his combo behind him, but it's not over quite yet. Here come the reinforcements. Can the Whales get the bomb off that they need? Hero has got two. Sizer with another. The heavy, I believe, is Blaze. That's actually huge, Sal. The heavy's doing a lot. Can he get him? Wow, the heavy.
Oh,
good lord. Dummy flies in at the very end here. Shade is pushing the point. He gets piped. What? Shade does go down. 1 second left. Are you kidding me? The Whales do it. They got it. Wow. Oh my god, that's crazy, Sal. I didn't think they would, but the heavy did so much at the end, and now it's tied up 3-3. Wow.
I just did one of those excited little laughs that you do when you're just like, I don't know what's happening right now.
Yeah, that was crazy. Dummy, that kill onto Shade was absolutely huge. He was so low that if Shade would have gotten like a nice ground fight against him, he probably would have won with regular needles. Woo! Okay, well, here we go. Last round. Can we stretch it out? Is there one more map of TF2 tonight? We'll find out. LG says no. And that first bit of mid as they take the point right away and drop two. Clockwork and Blaze go down early, but Dave is going to join them. And in the meantime, the whales are back at their last point, their spawn point, and they're going to try to regroup here, Sal. But wow, what an end of that round.
Yeah, it was. And I tell you what, DJC, I got a question for you. Clockwork has been going down, like, first in every fight. I guess we're going to see the Uber coming in here, but be thinking about that. I'm going to ask that again later. Banny down right away by Boomer, so this is a good Uber for them. The whales are going to capture right away. They need to escape the rest of this Uber from LG. Can Mezzer stay alive? This time looks like yes. Dave destroying
got
him.
Owned. Boomer like flew and double mid-aired him. Like they were both in the air. It wasn't a double, but that was awesome. I don't know if that was on stream or not, but that was pretty sick. DJC.
Oh, IZ 50 with the 3-rune blade kill. That's the reskin of the Boston Masher. DJC, I'm sorry. So Clockwork has been dying a lot, like before his team is ready to go. Is that affecting the whales?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, Clockwork right now is trying to play. He knows what he has to do. He has to kill Banny at the start of every fight because Banny is doing about as much damage as any other two players on LG combined. What that leads to is he's tunneling really hard, and Banny is actually on fire. Like, there was a period last round, where Banny hit five straight pipes right before he sucked down that arrow. So you can see right here, Clockwork and YZ focus down Banny. They move on to Hero. There's three down for LG. The Uber advantage is to the Space Whales. So this looks like a nice recap coming in here.
They're going to back off.
Space Whales are going to cap it.
Yeah, they're going to get the cap. Shade is back, and he's tucked away nice and safe looking at the clock. This round is looking like it's going to be yet another close one. I think the last three have been very, very close. Agonizingly close. You cannot have a closer round than last one. That was absolutely nuts. 2 minutes on the clock for LG and 2:15 and counting for the Whales. Both teams do have Uber Sal, so we're going to see a pretty important fight here. Could determine quite a bit in this round and the rest of this match, obviously.
Mezzer having to save his soldier here. Clockwork at one health, but at least he managed to escape to a health kit this time. And this scout over here is going to get some heals. I think that was going to be YZ50 actually taking the Uber and finishing off Dave.
Sorry, Sal, but interesting choice out of LG. They just tucked Shade away, didn't pop. So they got the force. I don't think that was their plan, but they got it. And Shade's like, well, I'm just going to go back. We'll have a full Uber advantage here. And so they're looking to take it. But in the meantime, the Whales have taken the lead here, and they're growing it out about 22 seconds and counting here as we're approaching the halfway mark, 130. But here comes the push. Hero is going to open it up onto Blaze, and wow, there's three right away. Shade has not popped his Uber yet. Dummy is trying, like, everything he possibly can, stickies and pipes and spam, to try to force the pop. But a textbook great push there from LG. Sal, they took the point back without having to pop Uber, and they're going to have a big foothold here, a chance to really have a big time suck. Here, time suck. Sure, why not?
Yeah, it's a new word invented here.
Straw on the thing.
Here on the ESEA stream, you heard it first. Seabear, of course, the master of the turn of phrase. But LG is going to get their enemies to pop the Uber first. This time around, Shade will actually pop, not going to try and tuck himself away again. But Blaze dying right away. Dave is very low health, and one health left on Dave now, but he manages to retreat just for the moment, finally taken down. Meanwhile, though, Boomer and Clockwork have died, so once again, three down for the Whales. They're not going to be able to recapture this. Not really even able to finish up any more kills here. And suddenly, things are once again looking up for Leviathan Gaming. I'm sure I'm keeping up all of my neighbors right now who aren't out on the town, but this is an incredible game.
Sal, your neighbor should be watching. Tell them to tune in. I don't know what they're missing out here. I got to point out, big question entering this game was whether or not Hero could step up and play with these teams. Three doms right now for Chad in this second half. So he's showing that he is a big-time player. Clockwork is going to go down yet again to the Banny spam. 50 seconds and counting. LG looks great right now. That recap, not having to pop, has proved to be a big-time suck.
they
just
have
keep
sucked
using
a lot of time,
right?
There you go. Yeah. No, they've sucked a lot of time down into the little drain here, and all of a sudden, Leviathan are looking so solid. They are going to have to deal with the Zuber coming in, but they've kited it very effectively. And now Shade does pop his own. He's going to try and force the Whales away from this point. You are going to see Blaze down already. Sizer gets eaten in return. Clockwork on the point here, but he is going to have to retreat from like four or five players. Mezzer down, and Shade still 150 health. So the med story here may tell the story of the game. Dave does get taken out. Clockwork is on a roll, but finally Hero will take him down. 10 seconds left. The Whales are pushing the point desperately, and Hero does get the kill on Boomer just as that point gets captured. Seabear, are the Whales going to be able to hold this for a minute and 18?
If they are, they're going to have to find some way to deal with this Uber that's going to come up. They're going to have Shade at 60%. They have to kill him or somehow kite this without... They really can't afford to give up the point. 4 seconds left is not enough time. It looks like they're opting to do just that, but how are they going to get on the point? There's only 1 second left. They're just not even going to get on it. That's it. That's the game. Unfortunate. Oh, man. The whales couldn't get on the point. And that is it. GGs go out, and our stream chat is nothing but GGs. Congratulations to Leviathan Gaming, and pretty good showing by the whales all land long, but they are out, Sal, and it is set. A rematch, the one that we all thought we'd see all land long. We're going to get it on Sunday. It's going to be LG versus Mixup.
LG versus Mixup. I mean, this is going to be LG's chance for revenge for I-46. I mean, so far Mixup have been undefeated in you know throughout the entire season and throughout the entire LAN. We'll see if they can actually keep that up. DJC, you have been relatively quiet, and I love hearing your analysis. It's beautiful.
Look at the damage! And holy crap!
What the hell else am I gonna say? Like, look at Banny's numbers. Like, here's the thing: nobody on Space Whales played poorly. Nobody really played poorly on LG either. But like. You could say, oh, there was a big difference in medics, because Shade did stay alive more. He did generally come out with uber advantages where Mezzer didn't. But really, it just comes down to, what the fuck can you do when Banny does that? Like, he did 530 damage a minute, and he had a 2-to-1 kill-death ratio where he died, like, 10 less times than any other combat class except for Dummy.
Yeah, I mean, the big story of that game, considering how close it actually ended up being, 3-4, when you have your demo outplay the other team's demo by that much, just look at the numbers. Jesus. What did you say his numbers were in the match earlier when they played?
5-10 damage per minute and like 47 to 20-something. So he bested that pretty easily.
That's like unheard of levels of damage. I think a good demo in a map that's a lot of play, like you're back and forth, I think somewhere around the mid to high 300s is considered a great game. When you top 500, even on a map with a lot of spamming like this map Viaduct obviously is, that's crazy. Like, frankly, that's amazing. Just look at it compared to everybody else. It's just, it's ridiculous. We should probably stop. I know I get accused all the time of S-ing Banny's D, but listen, guys, like, he's frankly a lot better than pretty much any other player. Platinum, we've seen, have a great series, great land so far, but Banny is freaking unbelievable.
Well, I want to extol the virtues here real quick of Hero as well, who was looking so solid there at the end of the game. And you mentioned it too, that Hero with the three dominations was definitely pulling out all the stops here for LAN, looking like he definitely deserves to be in invite at the top, and we'll see whether he can hold up against the Ruin Enigma combo tomorrow along with his fellow scout Sizer. What do you guys think is going to be happening tomorrow?
Well, I'm excited to see it. The Sunday has been weird before. It kind of depends, because a lot of teams, a lot of these players don't really sleep like normal people, like normal adults, so they'll be up probably pretty late. The guys that are more used to having a sleep schedule wake up fresh. We'll see pretty quickly tomorrow. I think the big story will be, can Banny go super crazy mode? But really, what is going to tell the difference is, can Tyrone play like he did at I-46? If yes, I think that LG actually has a pretty good chance. I frankly do. I know Clockwork isn't there, but we saw Sizer, when he gets hot, he can counter those two. But really, if Tyrone is able to play close to like he did at I-46, we'll see a series. If not, then I look for Mixup to have a pretty easy day. I don't know. What do you think, DJ?
It's really tough to gauge what's going to happen, because LG got tested really hard twice, and they came out on top both times by some very narrow margins. Mixup did not get a test. They kind of rolled over the chess club, and then they played a Whales team, and they had one half. The Whales had one good half against them, and it was two rounds. And everything else, Mixup just completely dominated. I mean, the only real comparison we have between these two teams right now is that Mixup dominated a team who were really close to LG in skill. And
well,
that doesn't tell us anything about what is going to happen with Mixup versus LG is the problem.
That's the only other LAN comparison, of course. But we did have that process match back at the end of the season.
Yeah, but online doesn't even matter, Sal. That's the problem. Like, if online mattered, people would have been predicting LG to finish third really badly behind the Space Whales, because after Clockwork joined the Whales looked like an entirely different team, and LG looked like they just struggled and couldn't figure anything out. Like, even their scrims were just so bipolar and so schizophrenic, and the Space Whales did random stuff like move Clockwork to Pocket and blazed a scout and then trashed all over LG. If stuff like that is happening online, I feel like we're at the point where we can just safely discard what happened online.
You're probably absolutely right. Now, I do want to point out that, as Rapture says in the stream chat, CSGO is still going on. If you're interested in seeing what's happening like with the Counter-Strike scene and why it still exists, maybe you should go watch that. twitch.tv/ESEA, no underscore orange. Get rid of that stuff, that'll be it.
I think one of my friends, a guy by the name of James, who I used to play Counter-Strike with when I was a wee boy, a long, long time ago, and he's for Area 51, which is my old team. I think he's in Counter-Strike GO, so I might go check that out just to see my guy James and see how he's doing. That would be fun. I've never seen or played a moment of CSGO, so I think I'm going to check that out just to see it.
I'd tell you what, I only got home in time for the last games of the day, and they were excellent. And if people were saying that the mix-up versus Space Whales game was even better than those, I don't know what
I'm gonna do. Yeah, the first half of that game was really awesome. It was the best half of TF2 I've seen, I think, in a long time. It really was. It was great.
Okay, well, I'm going to have to watch that one privately and in a padded room so nobody can hear me.
All right, well, be careful there. Don't poke an eye out, all right, Sal? All right, well, we should cut this off. Lang has done Yeoman's work, just sitting at his computer all day, eating bacon-flavored pizza like a man. But he is awesome. So let's do some shout-outs one more time. DJC probably has the list. I want to start with Lang, who has done everything so far. So big shouts to Lang. You're the man, Lang! We love you! And the chem work's been great. Struggled through some tech problems, but we finished strong. Big shout-out to ESCA for letting us cast this on the Orange stream. And a big shout-out to all you viewers. I love you guys. And hopefully we can top this number tomorrow and have a nice end to this LAN. It started out kind of poor, but I think the last games were well worth it. So thanks again, guys, for showing up. I'm going to give it to DJC, and he'll thank the rest of the people that need to be thanked. But, I love you guys. Thank you.
Obviously, big shout-out to Lang for his work on the camera today. Everything behind the scenes was pretty much done by Lang. Shout-out to his business associate, Sharpless6, who helped him out with some Photoshop stuff. Big thanks to Twitch TV John for pretty much everything he does for this community and everything he continues to do for this community and everything that he pretty much ever does, because he's pretty awesome. We got to thank Lame Effects and Mocha for their work in getting this publicized on Reddit, for keeping the Team Fortress TV Twitter up to date, for all the stuff they've been doing on pretty much every site that they possibly can find. I'm pretty sure there's going to be some random furry forum out there where Lame Effects went in and said, "Hey guys, TF2 has wolf hats." Try to get them drawn in. Thanks to Sean Budd and Admirable, who were with us and no longer are. Thanks to Sigma for that as well, because I actually forgot he was here, and I feel embarrassed. Thanks to Skyride and Comedian for the Vanilla TV stuff they hooked us up with. And thank you to Wreath for moderating the chat today. And Wreath, screw you, whoever
upwards
the hell
of 100 nerds. Big place for her. And girl gamers around the world. Thank you.
And I was going to say screw you to whoever was banning the people posting Mr. Slynn's Twitch chat. And we're going to find you, because you can do that, apparently.
Yeah. All right. So, Sal, any shout-outs for you before I guess I can throw it away? Throw it to the Sunday finals. Actually, can we get confirmation on when exactly it is?
11:30 a.m. Eastern, 10:30 a.m. Central.
All right. So 10:30 Central, 11:30 Eastern.
That's 13 hours from now, basically.
Yes.
13 hours from right now. So set your clocks.
So everyone should get to bed early and get some sleep so we can enjoy the finals tomorrow. It's going to be LG versus Mixup. Definitely worth watching. Go ahead,
all right, well. Okay, so shout-out number one, he has been spamming me on Steam. This is Fog for his Acts of Pizza.
Oh, yeah, I forgot Fog. Sorry, Fog. Honestly, did not think of it because I didn't actually get my pizza.
If you guys didn't know, yeah, Fog actually bought each of us casters a pizza, even though I only showed up, like, really late and I don't deserve one. He went ahead and bought all of us one because he's the greatest guy. But also, I do need to shout out X Television. I've been, you know, casting over there for quite a long time, and despite the drama bomb that ended our chances of casting this particular LAN, yeah, boo boo, I know.
I'm just kidding.
but no, despite that, XTV is still going strong, and of course, we've got that documentary well in the works. I can't give you an estimated date of arrival on that, but yeah, we're gonna get that I-46 documentary out there maybe within the next year. You know,
maybe in the next decade. Who knows?
But then, of course, I want to real quick shout out to my channel as well. Those of you who are here, there's like 1,000 of you. You're probably already subscribed. I don't know. If you're not, YouTube.com/FatMop. That's where I put, you know, TF2 videos. And now I'm actually doing some Dwarf Fortress too, which is just awesome. It's so much fun.
Oh my god, you're such a nerd.
I know.
Yeah,
I know.
Seriously, I play Crusader Kings, and I still feel like I have enough grounds to call you a nerd.
You do. It's true.
All right. For me, I also want to echo EX Television. TeamFortress.tv, I'm sure all of you guys left are diehards, and you know that. But if you don't, TeamFortress.tv, not only can you see Fat Mop's TF2 stream, but you can see all of the great TF2 streams, including Lang, who's done everything, like I said, Sean, who cast it earlier, and sometimes when I stream, a little Bear TV top flying Twitch TV /CBEARR. It's me in the chat. Anyway, dudes, I think that's going to do it for us. I'm not sure if Lang is planning on doing anything with the stream, leaving it on, maybe a little longer if we're just going to cut it out. But I want to see every single one of you nerds.